Welcome back. Now it's time for our daily press review, and we start off from Al Wafda newspaper, and we read the following headline: President Abdel Fattah Sisi meets his Iraqi counterpart and receives call from Russian President. President Abdel Fattah Sisi met on Monday with his Iraqi counterpart Fouad Masoum in the presidential palace in Cairo. During the visit, they discussed boosting bilateral relations as well as regional files. President Sisi stressed the historic and distinctive relations between the two countries and peoples. More in the following report.
President Abdel Fattah Sisi held summit talks with Iraqi counterpart Fouad Masoum in his first official visit to Cairo that will take 3 days. Presidential spokesman Ala Yusuf said that the President Sisi asserted during the talks Egypt's stance towards supporting the Iraqi unity and its sovereignty on its lands, adding that Egypt is also keen to restore security and stability in the country. President Sisi also discussed with the Iraqi president means of boosting bilateral relations in various fields. For his part, the Iraqi president hailed Egypt's efforts to maintain stability in Iraq, as well as its role to contain the crisis in the Middle East. The current developments on the region, as well as issues of mutual concern, were also tackled during the meeting.
And moving to Al-Youm Al-Saba, where we read that Prime Minister heads the economic group meeting. Prime Minister Sharif Ismail headed on Monday the economic group meeting. During the meeting, Ismail discussed with the ministers the latest developments of the country's economic status and the government program to support the exports. The Prime Minister also followed up the projects that the government is working on and the availability of the supply goods and the development of the consumer centers. The Prime Minister also discussed the One Window project, as well as providing the necessary climate for the investors and for attracting the investments.
Moving to Parliament, and we read the following headline: House of Representatives approves Parliament regulations. The House of Representatives on Monday approved in general the draft rules for the Parliament regulations. The House of Representatives has been discussing for many sessions the report prepared by the special committee which was formed to prepare the Parliament regulations. Earlier, the chairman of the committee that took charge of drafting the regulation, Abu Shoka, told reporters that the coming articles are highly important because they deal with controversial issues such as procedures necessary to strip an MP of his parliamentary immunity or membership.
Indeed, and moving to the Egyptian news from where we read. Defense Minister witnesses a number of training activities for the Marine Special Units. Minister of Defense and General Commander of the Armed Forces, Lieutenant General Sudi Subhi, witnessed on Monday a number of training activities carried out by the elements of the Marine Units. The General Commander of the Armed Forces praised what he saw from the distinguished level in implementing specialized tasks with reflection to the level of efficiency and combat readiness of the Marine Units. The Minister of Defense urged them to continue efforts in training and maintain fitness and high morale. In a meeting with the Marine Forces fighters, the Defense Minister conveyed President Abdel Fattah Sisi's greetings and appreciation to the effort they exert to secure the country. The Defense Minister praised the Egyptian martyrs who sacrificed their lives and their blood in defense of the security of Egypt and its great people. The General Commander of the Armed Forces also pointed out to the risks and the challenges that are facing Egypt on both the international and internal levels.
Moving to Al-Youm Al-Saba newspaper, and we read the following headline: OIC summit concludes with the Jakarta declaration. The fifth organization of Islamic conference, the OIC extraordinary summit, concluded on Monday as all country members approved the Jakarta declaration resulted from the two-day high-level talks. The Jakarta Declaration reaffirmed OIC member countries' support on the recognition of the Palestinian people's self-determination, including the right of independence, with Al-Quds Sharif as the Palestinian state's capital. The document also pledged commitment to fully support for the National Unity Government under the leadership of Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas. In his speech before the summit, Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry said the Palestinian cause is a cornerstone of security in the region. On the sidelines of the summit, Shoukry met with Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas in Jakarta. Abbas discussed with Shoukry the latest in the constant Israeli violations on Palestinian territories. The Palestinian Authority requested to hold the summit following the increase of Israeli violence in the recent months and the restriction of access to Al-Aqsa Mosque. Over 500 delegates from 49 OIC member states attended the event, in addition to four representatives from the Quartet on the Middle East, five UN Security Council representatives, and three observer countries.
Mm-hmm. And moving to Al-Watan, from where we read, Egypt officially nominates Ahmed Abu Ghait to head the Arab League. Egypt on Monday officially nominated former Foreign Minister Ahmed Abu Ghait as the head of the Arab League. Foreign ministers from 22 countries constituting the League will vote on Abu Ghait's appointment on Thursday at a Cairo summit. No other country has nominated a Secretary General, with the Egyptian traditionally voted to head the League. The nomination comes following current Secretary General Nabil Arabi's announcement that he would not pursue a second term. Al-Arabi took over as League Chief from fellow Egyptian diplomat Amr Moussa in 2011. Al-Arabi's term will end on the 30th of June.
Moving to Al-Shuruq newspaper, and we read Tourism Minister heads to Germany. Tourism Minister Hisham Zazwa heads to Germany on Tuesday to participate in Berlin Bourse for Tourism, which is considered the biggest tourism bourse in the world. The minister is heading a delegation from government and private tourism sector in Egypt. Zazwa is expected to hold a series of meetings with media and tourism experts. Earlier, the tourism minister discussed with the Chinese ambassador to Egypt ways of increasing the number of Chinese tourists visiting Egypt. The meeting also tackled the importance of working on increasing flights between both countries. Zazwa also urged the Chinese ambassador to persuade Chinese airlines to schedule more flights between the two countries. Zazwa expressed the ministry's readiness to support flights coming from China, besides launching promotional campaigns for Chinese airlines. For his part, the Chinese ambassador expressed his happiness with the meeting, pointing out to the depth of Egyptian-Chinese relations. He said that he will discuss with the competent Chinese authorities to schedule more flights between the two countries. He also invited tourism minister to attend the World Conference for Tourism Development Festival, which will be held in China in cooperation with the World Tourism Organization.
Mm-hmm. And moving to Elion Seba, Egypt condemns militant attack on a Tunisian town. Egypt strongly condemned the terrorist attack that targeted the army and police post in the Tunisian town of Ben Gurdim near the Libyan border on Monday, killing at least 50 people. Foreign Ministry spokesman Councilor Ahmed Abu Zeid extended Egypt's deepest condolences to the Tunisian government and people. Abu Zeid affirmed Egypt's solidarity with Tunisia in fighting terrorism, reiterating its call for the countries to work on coordination and to coordinate the international effort to defeat it. Earlier, Tunisian security forces fought off fierce attacks with extremists near the Libyan border. And the government closed its two border crossings with Libya and imposed curfew in Ben Gurdim following the attack that left 28 terrorists, 7 civilians, and 10 members of Tunisia security forces dead. Meanwhile, Tunisian President Brigitte El Qaid Sisi denounced the extremist attacks as unprecedented and coordinated assaults. In statement broadcast on the state television, Sisi said the assault that killed 28 terrorists was mainly aimed at controlling the border region with Libya and vowed to exterminate those terrorists.
And moving to Al-Wafd newspaper, and we read the following headline: Egypt's stock markets gains £1.95 billion. Egypt's stock market closed Monday's trading session in the green territory, extending Sunday's gains. The benchmark EGX 30 added 0.75% to reach 6,261 points, backed by the purchases of institutions. The small and mid-cap EGX 70 also rose 0.56% to 355 points. Likewise, the broader index EGX 100 notched up 0.23% to 730. The weight index AGX 50 and ended 1.01% higher at 1,203 points. Markets capital gained £1.95 billion, moving up to £398.14 billion from £396.19 billion. And now, dear viewers, this was the last piece of news in this edition of the Press Review. But before we wrap up our press, actually, we have a report about the performance of the Egyptian stock market.
Egypt's stock market indices collectively went up during yesterday's trading session, affected by strong purchasing operations by Arab and foreign financial institutions and investment funds. Arab and foreign investors were net buyers of shares, so their purchasing operations surged to exceed sales by local investors in different categories. The day's trading saw the market's capital gain around 2 billion Egyptian pounds, closing at 398.1 billion pounds after dealings worth around 773.9 million pounds. The main EGX 30 index jumped by 0.75%. The small and medium-sized EGX 70 went up by 0.56%, while the more expanded EGX 100 jumped by 0.23% to end the day.
And our dear viewers, with this report about the performance of the Egyptian stock market, we come to the end of our press review for today. Now we'll go to a short break, and after that we'll be back to resume the segments of the breakfast show. So don't go away.